There is no one like you, God. Yeah, you are a great and awesome God. You are a perfect Father. So, Father, we just come before you with open hearts and open arms, ready to receive everything that you have for us, especially that love, that strong love that you have for us, God. Oh, how we love to worship you. How we love to adore you, Father God. Yeah. Just allow him to love you this morning. Allow him to just give you that embrace. We lift our hands towards heaven this morning, God. And we receive your love. We embrace you, Father God. Kiss us, God, with your tender and loving kindness and your mercy and your compassion. Yeah, surround us with your presence this morning, Holy Spirit. Whether we're sitting in our bedrooms, in our living rooms, in our kitchens, God, we stand before you in awe. And we receive your love and your presence in our lives. You are so worthy, Jesus. You are so worthy of our praise. And with the angels we sing to you, you are holy. Holy, holy you, God, you are almighty. You are worthy of our praise. God, just begin to give him the worship. It's not about the songs. It's not about the melody. Jesus is looking at your hearts this morning. And he wants all that is within you. He wants this wholehearted heart. Only for him. How we love you, Jesus. We just want to bask in your presence, God. Saturate us with your love. Flood our hearts, God, with your fire, with your love, with your mercy. God is just flooding your homes right now. He's invading your hearts right now. And so just open your hearts to him. And just receive him. Yeah, he's flooding your hearts with his love. Respond to him. Just respond to him. Yeah. You're all we want, Jesus. You're all we want, Jesus. Nothing else. Nothing else but you. Yeah.
Thank you. You are perfect in nature. I know that already created the concept me from your love. Yep, joy, laughter, the angels know powers present in your things in the future. I know that already created the concept me from your love. Yep, joy, laughter, the angels know powers. Oh. your head is white as wool. I know that your voice, it sounds like waters. Jesus, you're beautiful. I know that your eyes are like the flames of fire. I know that your head is white as wool. I know that your voice, it sounds like waters. Jesus, you're beautiful.
just wanna move your heart. It's all I wanna do. I just wanna stand in awe and pour my love on you, no matter how much the cost. Really give it all to you, all to you.
I freely give it all to you.
here I give my vows. Is it a song I sing? Then here's every melody. Just tell me what moves you. Tell me what moves you. Is it a fragrance? Then I'll pour my oil out. Is it a life laid down? Then here I give my vows. Is it a song I sing? Then here's every melody. Just tell me what moves you. Tell me what moves you. Is it a fragrance? Is it a fragrance that I'll pour my oil out? Is it a life laid down? Then here I give my vows. Is it a song I'll sing? Then here's every melody. Just tell me what moves you. Tell me what moves you. I just want to move your heart. Caught within your gaze, precious God, is where I want to stay. Oh, just to dwell in your house. Waste my hours and my days on you. I just want to move your heart. Caught within your gaze, right here in your presence, God. It's where I want to stay, oh, just to dwell in your house. It's my hours and my days on you. You know, God's heart was moved. Three people that I can think of: by David, by Mary of Bethany, and by John the Beloved. David set his heart towards God. That in every occasion, out of all these enemies and wars coming up against him, he desired of this one thing: to seek God's face and to dwell in his house all the days of his lives. And then we see John, he called himself the Beloved. It's not because God called him the Beloved, Jesus called him the Beloved, but he felt, he understood and knew the love of Jesus for him, that he called himself the Beloved. And then we have this Mary. That probably all she had in her bank account was a year worth of wages. Yet, bought this perfume, bought this oil, this fragrance, and broke it. Broke this jar and poured it at the feet of Jesus. And poured it on Jesus to anoint him. And every time Mary sat at the feet of Jesus, Jesus is so pleased with her. That at one time, we know this story with Martha and Mary. Jesus had to tell Mary, "Stop worrying, Mary. You're doing all these works. But look at Mary." I'm sorry. Jesus told Martha to stop worrying because she's doing all these works. And he told Mary, look at and he told Jesus told Martha, look at Mary. She knew that one thing is needed. This is what Jesus said. One thing is needed. Luke 10:38. One thing is needed. And Mary chose to do the good part. You see, Jesus does not forbid us in doing the things that we need to do here on earth. But we get so caught up with those things that we miss that one thing that is needed. Jesus, this is Jesus' words to Martha in Luke 10:38, 39, 40. One thing is needed, and Mary chose the good part. We can bring all these good things to Jesus, all the works, our offerings, our gifts, our talents. But one thing that moves his heart is our wholehearted heart for him. Not partial, not 99.9%. Whole, 100% of our hearts only for him. So I feel like this morning that's the word for us. Luke 10:38. One thing is needed, and Mary chose the good part. Are we going to choose the good part? God is not going to force us. But are we going to choose the good part? Are you ready to pour out your oil at the feet of Jesus? Are you ready to lay your life for him? Give him the vow that he longs to hear. Jesus, you are all I want. Jesus, you're all I need. Apart from you, Jesus, I can do nothing. Are you ready to give your song to him, your melody to him? Are you ready to waste your hours and your days just to sit at the feet of Jesus? In this hour that we are living in, desires for us to draw closer to him. He's not far from us. He's always near us. But we're the ones who's choosing to be far away from him. And so let's choose the good part this morning. Let's choose just be at the feet of Jesus. It doesn't matter what you're doing. While you're working, while you're, I don't know, taking care of your kids, driving, doing ministry. always near us. And so, Father, this morning, we bring to you more than a song. We bring to you more than our offerings. We bring to you more than our monies. And we give to you a wholehearted heart. A heart that only beats for you. A heart that burns in fire only for you, Jesus. Flood our hearts this morning with your love. Captivate us over and over again with your beauty and your majesty as we behold and gaze upon you. We just want to be with you. Nothing compares to being in your presence, Jesus. Nothing. So this morning we just give you our vow. We will choose to know you, to love you more than ever before. This encounter change us, change our perspective, change our mindsets, God. We will always desire and long for you. We will be filled and be full of your love. You created all things through you and for you. You created us for you. So we give to you what belongs to you, our whole hearts and hearts. Yes, we pray in Jesus' name.